Yo guys, what's going on? It's Rush here, bringing you guys a brand new video. We are here in the PDD week 3, taking on Lily and her wiki-watchy wishy-washies. Sorry if I pronounced it incorrectly. Very excited for this matchup. I've never played Lily before, so I really don't have any idea of how she is going to play. But let's hope that this goes well. We definitely need a bounce back win after last week. Sorry there was no upload. I had a lot of technical issues and it just didn't work out for me to get that video out for you guys, so I apologize for that, but go ahead and watch my opponent's side if you want to know exactly how everything, you know, squeaked out. Bottom line is we lost last week. We're hoping to pick up a win this week and go 2-1. Let's see if this is, you know, this is our game in order, you know, to do that. Let's go over the matchup real quick before we go into what we're bringing and why we're bringing it. If you have missed our draft analysis and our first game, our team is Latios, Iron Hands, Azumarill, Crocodile, Terra, Electric, Poison, Fairy, Cresselia, Hisuian Gudra, Talonflame, Terra, Grass, Poison, Ground, Appleton, Overquill, Tinkatuff, and Wartortle. Whereas my opponent has Iron Valiant, Dragonite, Mesprit, Goldengo, Vikavolt, Zangoose, Terra, Steel, Dark, Poison, Cobalion, Weavile, Terra, Rock, Water, Flying, Rhydon, and Quillfish. A lot of interesting mons on my opponent's team. I have not seen Terra Rhydon yet, so that's really cool. I've seen a lot of Terra Rhyperior, but not Terra Rhydon. So definitely very interested to see how that, if that shows up. Cobalion can be a massive issue for me. I really don't have a ton to deal with it. Valiant is always an issue to deal with. Dragonite, I'm really not sure if they're going to want to bring it, just because I have some decent mons to deal with it, like the Latios and the Azumarill, for example. It's something that'll be an interesting matchup for sure. I think we have the upper hand here. I think Cresselia has a phenomenal matchup here as always. But let's go ahead and let's see what we're bringing and why we're bringing it. First up, we're bringing pick one, our Latios, with the Choice Scarf this week with Flip Turn, Draco Meteor, Psychic, and Shadow Ball. We're just running max speed, max special attack with a Timid nature. Mainly this is so I can potentially outpace a Scarf Cobalion if she wants to bring that. But also this outpaces non-booster speed Iron Valiant. This outspeeds plus one Dragonite. This outspeeds basically all of his Choice Scarfers if they decide to show up. Draco is really free into my opponent's team outside of Valiant and Goldengo. Psychic for the Valiant and Shadow Ball for the Goldengo. But yeah, I think Latios has a very, very good matchup this week to just really click a lot of buttons. But also Scarf Flip Turn is very good to get some positioning for myself. So hopefully we are able to get that positioning correct this week. And next up, we are bringing Marge, our Azumarill, with the Heavy Duty Boots and the Huge Power ability with Aqua Jet, Play Rough, Liquidation, and Knockoff. We're just running max HP, max attack, Adamant Nature. This is like a little bit of a Dragonite check. I think max HP, this thing does take one hit from plus one Dragonite. So if we can offensively bring that in as they Dragon Dance, potentially we can live that hit and then do some really solid damage. Outside of that, this thing's pretty solid. I mean, Liquidation plus Play Rough is really good in my opponent's team outside of Quillfish, where we can just, you know, potentially get a knockoff on a switch in. Outside of that, my opponent has a really hard time switching into this. If they're Terra Water Rhydon, that obviously changes things. I'd honestly prefer that because that means, you know, we could actually deal with it pretty well with a lot of our team members. But yeah, I think Azumarill here is very, very solid. I think Play Rough and Liquidation, like I said, is very good in my opponent's team outside of Quillfish. But we'll see how that shakes out this week. Next up, we're bringing our MVP this season, Cresselia. Good luck, have fun, the Cresselia with the leftovers. The Terra Fairy this week with Terra Blast, Shadow Ball, Substitute, and Calamine. I'll break the fourth wall a little bit. I've already played this game. I completely forgot, even though I've already used Moonblast Cresselia, I completely forgot that Cresselia gets Moonblast. So in my brain, I was like, you know what? I need Terra Blast because I need a Fairy Stab for this game. I completely forgot that that Moonblast is a move for whatever reason. I don't know what I was thinking, but Fairy and Ghost is very, very solid in my opponent's team outside of a couple of mons, i.e. the Quillfish is the only thing I don't really hit for like super effective or neutral. Neutral I hit with Shadow Ball, but Shadow Ball's not doing too much if they are special defensive set. But if I can start getting some Calm Minds up and they don't bring the Zangoose, I can actually put in a ton of work with this Cresselia. Cresselia is very, very good in this matchup. If we can position it properly then Cresselia can honestly just win the game, which is kind of a normal thing for Cresselia this season. He's already gotten one sweep under its belt. Let's see if I can get another one. Next up, we're bringing Burden, our Hisuian Goodra with the leftovers, Flash Cannon, Flamethrower, Ice Beam, Knockoff. We're just running a full Spadef set this week. I could have ran the Assault Vest. I just wanted the leftovers longevity more so than anything, and the special attackers that this thing, that my opponent has. I'm mainly the Vikavolt and the Goldango. This is mostly a Goldango check, which is why I'm running Flamethrower. I'm not running any Dragon Stab this week. I don't feel like I need Dragon Stab because the whole thing with Dragon Stab is I would hit the Dragonite, and Ice Beam honestly just does that better since it's quad effective. It also hits the Pre-Terra Rhydon for super effective. But yeah, honestly, I think these moves are pretty solid in my opponent's team. I think Goodra can be pretty solid for us if we position it correctly, as a pretty solid defensive check to my opponent's team. Next up, we are bringing Bird Brigade, our Talonflame with the boots and the Flame Body ability. We're running U-Turn, Flare Blitz, Roost, and Defog. We're running full HP, full speed. This way, I can outpace the Weavile no matter what, unless it's like a Choice Scarf set or something. Flare Blitz, I believe, still Oko's. The Weavile, I don't expect them to stay in with this or anything like that. U-Turn, I think, does like half to the Weavile. So, Talonflame is really solid in this matchup. I can get some potential Flame Body burns on like a Weavile, for example, when it tries to knock off. A U-Turning Mesprit, potentially. A Dragonite trying to hit me for, with like a Dragon Claw or something. I can potentially get there's a lot of Mons on my opponent's team. Cobalion, depending on the set they want to bring. I can also hit with a Flame Body proc, which would be amazing. I really do think Talonflame is really just here for pivoting and just kind of like a utility bring this week, which is kind of its role a lot of this season. So hopefully I'm able to position myself well with this Talonflame, and we'll see how that goes in the game. And last but certainly not least, we're bringing Evil Puff, our Overquill with the Black Sludge, Intimidate ability, Bar Barrage, Crunch, Taunt, and Spikes with 248 HP, 244 defense with an Impish Nature, and 16 speed. The speed is so that way I can outpace a non-speed Quillfish since we are the same speed stat. And I can potentially get the Taunt off on their Quillfish, start setting up my own Spikes, and prevent them from setting up theirs. Overquill is also pretty solid as a physically defensive Valiant check. If they want to bring like a close combat Spirit Break set, I can deal with that really well. This is also a really good Weavile check. But yeah, guys, let me know what you think of the team down below, and I'll see you guys in the battle. Peace out. Yo, what's going on, guys? It's Rose here, bringing you guys a brand new video. We are here in the PDD taking on Lily. Very interesting matchup here. She brought most of what I expected. I'm very glad Terra Rhydon did not show up, because that would have actually given me a lot of issue. Looking a little bit farther into it, there's no Goldango, which is a little interesting. She does bring Dragonite. I didn't really expect the Dragonite to show up, but not the worst thing. I do have to watch out for the Koba. It's Terra Steel, Poison, Dark. So that's something I have to keep an eye on. I want to keep Azu around, because that way I can deal with the Weavile. No webs, so my boots on Azu are a little useless. But good luck, have fun. I'm leading Overquill. Hopefully I can get some spikes up. Lily brought no removal, which is nice. So I can hopefully get up some hazards quickly. Or if she leads Mesprit, then I'll just crunch Quillfish. Cool, that's fine. I'm fine with that. Alright, so mine goes off. She doesn't know that I am, like, not speedy, but I have a little bit of speed. I think I want to get my... Actually, I'm going to taunt, because I think they're going to try and spike first as well. Fell for the taunt. Teehee! That's exactly what I wanted to happen. Now I get a free spike. I put a little bit of I put like 36 speed into this, just so I can outpace the Quillfish if there's no speed. For that, like, almost for that exact specific scenario. So, it's probably, if I had to guess, physically defensive. I'm gonna spike up real quick. She's probably gonna flip turn out. if you flip turn out, depending on what you go, I either can go Talonflame on the Cobalion, or if you go Valiant, I'd probably go Talonflame either way. Mesprit. I'm going to get a crunch off. I'm getting a crunch off. Mesprit's an interesting... Unless they're trying to bait... getting a... They're probably trying to bait getting... the justified boost on Koba. I'm gonna get a spike up again. See what they want to do. Alright, I'm gonna be faster than this. Which is fine. Which means I know he has zero speed. Stealth Rock. That's fine. Interesting you go for Stealth Rock knowing I could have just clicked Taunt right there. Very interesting. I'm gonna crunch now. I think. Yeah, I'm gonna crunch. I'm gonna crunch here. Pop a Culber Berry. That's nice to know. Did about 20% with Culber. You have a lot of investment. You're probably max biz def. Yeah, max biz def is what it looks like. Brings in the Koba. I am. So you are Terra, Steel, Poison, Dark. I'm going to... I can go Talonflame here. I'm gonna go into Talonflame, see what they want to do. Let's see. Bird Brigade comes out. Iron Defense, that's fine. I will... I am going to just Flare Blitz, I think. I could Defog, get rid of the rocks. You could Stone Edge here. I think that's fine. I'm actually losing Talonflame would suck. I'm gonna U-turn. He is gonna Terra. We're gonna find out what, or she is gonna Terra. We're gonna find out what her Terra is right now. Terra Dark. That is perfect in this scenario. They're like nothing. Yeah, that's about right. I think I'll go into this. Because if you are... body press... see, Overquill. It does 2-hit KO. I'm gonna go into this anyways, I think. Stone's Dig. I mean, yeah. Terra Blast. Oh, that's perfect. Perfect. It's not going to do anything. Beautiful. I am going to get a nice little Barb Barrage off, I think. How many spikes did I get up before? I think 2, right? Yeah. I'm just going to get a Barb Barrage. Hopefully I can get a poison here. No poison. Okay. So Terra Blast, Body Press, Iron Defense,
Am I putting this thing in range of Latios Draco? I am. This is in range now. I'm gonna actually go into Bird Brigade here. Just in case he wants to body press again. just in case she wants to body press again, I could potentially pick up a flame body burn. Damn. Okay. I'm gonna roost, see what you want to do. This is really good. Really good for me. Yeah, body press did 171. 52, that's a min roll. On max impish. Potentially I could force this thing out. So, what's your... Roost, I'm gonna do it. We're gonna see. I'll lose my flying typing, so I'll probably drop here. Rest, okay. So rest of Chesto. Chesto bear, that tells me exactly what I needed. Perfect, okay. I could defog here, get rid of rocks. I'm gonna do that. Get rid of rocks. I would love a burn. I would love a burn. Terra Blast, that's fine. Minus one. This might not knock me out. Does nothing, which is amazing. 251, is that range for body press? 70%? No. Even a little bit of Flare Blitz chip. So, I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna Flare Blitz. Get a little bit of chip off. I'm basically pressuring this to do something. I think what they're trying to do is they're trying to force me to roost. Let's see. Iron Defense, Body Press, Terra Blast, Rest. They actually can't touch Azu. They can't touch Azu at all. No. Body Press doesn't 2-hit KO. Oh, we're gonna get a Flare Blitz off on something. This is gonna be very nice damage. Weavile! This is beautiful. This actually just knocks it out if he's not Sash. If this is not a Sash Weavile. Beautiful. Beautiful. Absolutely amazing. Talonflame kills Weavile with Flare Blitz. I'm so glad I made that play. It wasn't really like a predictive play. I just wanted to get a little bit of chip off that. excuse me. Ended up working out in my favor. I'll take that every day of the week. Absolutely every day of the week. They know my full set now. They know I can't touch the Quillfish, so they probably could go Quillfish here. And I probably... Because I don't think you're going to want to... lose Quillfish. I think you want to keep Quillfish around. Goes into Dragonite. Interesting play. I'm going to U-turn out and then go into my Scarf Latios. Yes? Yes. Dragonite. Latios will... You could Dragon Dance. I think my safer play is to actually go into Azu. I think my safer play is to go Azu.
I don't want to risk... Yeah, I'm not going to risk my Latios this early. I'm not doing that. I'm going to play safer a little bit. Maybe I should have... Play Rough actually kills here. And I live a plus one hit. So... unless this... let me check the wing bait. Yeah, I do. Play Rough is actually very free into this team. Obviously outside of Quillfish, which they could do right here. It's an Earthquake. This should not do much. That's fine. Land, and beautiful Dragonite is gone.
Azu kills Dragonite with Play Rough.
That is fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. We're doing well so far. We're doing well. Iron Valiant does come out. Are you scarfed? Or booster speed? You are booster speed. Okay. I think I get a little bit of chip on this, and then I go into my Cress. I think that's my play. Jet does about 30. I'm just going to get a nice little bit of chip off. And then I go Cresselia. That's massive damage. Thunderbolt comes out. Predicting Talonflame. Okay, that's fine. Azu, you did well. You did absolutely fantastic. Val kills Azu with T-Bolt. Okay, I go Cress. Itera. Maybe a sub. No, I think I go into this and Itera. Because this forces... What does this do? Let's see. Cresselia. Shadow Ball, but I'm gonna Terra Fairy, so it's not gonna do a whole lot. Yeah. I'm gonna Terra Blast. They go switch out. What do they switch into? Is it Quillfish? Cobalion. This might get rid of Cobalion. Not quite. That's... I'm okay with this. This is not gonna do a ton. Interesting that you choose to do this. I probably call mine. This should do a decent bit. Oh, shit. Was that a crit? No. What the fuck? I mean, sure. Let's see. Terra Blast, Body Press, Iron Defense, Rest. He can't touch me. Or this Cobalion cannot touch me. So I'm gonna sub. I am going to sub. I'll take it. Mesprit. I'm okay with this too. This is fine. Mesprit does taunt, correct? I believe Mesprit does taunt. I'm gonna double check, but I'm pretty sure. No, it does not taunt. I am glad I checked this out. So I am actually going to call mine. This is really good for me. Really, really, really good for me. Oh, I see what I did. I didn't check with the Terra Calc on Cobalion, because I just checked with base Cobalion. Yeah, that's looking about right then. Okay. Cool. Yeah, I Calm Mind. Because unless that Quillfish has Poison Jab, I don't think they can break my sub. Barbarage does not break sub. Liquidation. Yeah, it has to be Poison Jab. Or Gunk Shot, obviously. This is fine. Plus one. Ice Beam, that's not going to break sub. Sook damage. Perfect. All right. And Cresselia is looking to pick up a sweep here. I'm going to do this again. Now I should... Let's see, I'm going to do this. If you want to encore me, I don't think you can... Actually, can Mesprit encore? It could. She won't, though. Which tells me that could have been a Scarf Mesprit. Actually, no, it's not Scarf. It was Culber Berry. I knew that. I am going to... Calm Mind again. Just in case this breaks up. I'm in a winning effort here. So I'm going to be plus three. Which is phenomenal. Ice Beam might break my sub here. If it does, I'll just sub. Sub. Break. No break. Wow. Wow. I'm gonna calm mine. I want them to break my sub so I can get a fresh sub. This is plus four. Cresselia is evil. Why did they let me do this? Interesting. Opts for the healing wish. Mesprit dies to healing wish. Cress on field. I don't know if that's going to count for a kill towards Cress or not. Because some leagues do it to where it's like whatever the mon is on the field, if it's a self-KO with like Life Orb or Healing Wish or something. Valiant comes in. I will sub here. I think. Or do I just go for the damage? Actually, I just go for damage. Because Koba can't do any damage to me. Quillfish I'm not scared of. I'm just going to kill. I'm just going to go for the kill. Moonblast, that might break my sub. Might. There we go. The sub finally breaks. Kills. Iron Valiant with Terra Blessed. Beautiful. Cresselia is a fucking demon. Cresselia is a demon. I might not get welcome back after this season. I might not. Quillfish. This is fine. Poison Jab does about 30. I will Shadow Ball. Plus 4 is a 2-hit KO. Beautiful. Barb Barrage. This is fine. That's fine. Which means they didn't have the thing. Mesprit I need to get rid of because it's gone. So it's just this and Koba. Terra Blast. Yeah, I mean, I could Terra Blast and predict the Koba to come in, but I'm not going to. Cresselia kills Quillfish with Shadow Ball. And then Cresselia's going to pick up the kill on the Koba, because it's, what, Terra Blast, Body Press, Iron Defense, and Rest, so it can't touch me at all. Very interesting set for the Kobalion, considering she knows that I can very easily do exactly what I'm doing right now. Because Terra Fairy was one of my types. And she opted to almost bring nothing for it. Which I thought was interesting. But GG's to Lily here. Cress once again proving that it's disgusting and broken. And probably should not have been allowed to Terra. That was a crit. Kobalion with Terra Blast. And that's going to do it for week 3 of the PDD. We are bouncing back after a little bit of a rough loss last week. GG's to Lily. She did bring an interesting team. Some stuff I didn't expect. I very much thought Goldengo was going to show up. to maybe try and stop this from happening. But regardless, you know, she prepped well. Just Cresselia is a demon and should not be allowed. So I'll see you guys in week 4 of the PDD. Peace out.